Whether you're a tourist, a resident, or you want to retire in Cambodia, you'll need to get a visa. In this video, we will give you information on the types of visas you will need for your stay in Cambodia. Tourist visas are very easy to organize, but long stay visas have gotten a little more complicated. Until recently, you could get a long-term visa for Cambodia easily, and renew it indefinitely. The rules were tightened in 2019, giving clear preference for those who are locally employed or are retired. 1. Tourist visas. A tourist visa is for those who will be staying for 30 days or less. The 30-day tourist visa is available to travelers in advance or on arrival for $30 if you get it directly at the airport. The tourist visa is a single entry only, but you can renew the visa for an additional 30 days for a fee of between $30 and $50. After that, you will need to leave Cambodia and come back to obtain a new visa. 2. E-class visa. If you want to stay in Cambodia for an extended period, you will need to apply for a 30-day E-class visa when you arrive. This visa is also valid for 30 days and costs $35. The difference between the E-class visa and the tourist visa is that the E-class visa can be extended indefinitely. After 30 days, when you go to extend your visa, you can choose an EB, EG, ER or ES visa extension, known as an EOS, or extension of stay. Previously, there was only one E-class visa extension, known as the business or ordinary visa. Recently, a new set of E-class extension of stay types became available. Do not confuse them with E-class online visas. The four E-class visas are EB visa extension. The EB business visa covers most Cambodian expats, including those who are working, their partners, children and volunteers. The current rules require applications to provide a stamped letter verifying their employment with a Cambodian company. This visa extension can last for 1 to 3, 6, or 12 months, although only the 6 and 12-month visa extension will allow multiple entries. EG visa extension. The EG visa is for those looking for employment, and can last 1 to 3 or 6 months. They are not really for people who have been in Cambodia for a long time, but you may be able to get one if you previously held an EB visa. ER visa extension. The retirement visa extension is meant for those of retirement age who can show documentation of retirement in their home country, such as a pension or social security, and prove that they have the funds to support themselves. ER visa extensions are usually only granted to those who are 55 and older. If you are 55 or older, you are not usually asked to show evidence of retirement and proof of savings is usually enough. The ER visa extension can't be used if the visa holder is employed, but holders of this visa extension do not need to get a work permit. The ER retirement visa extension can be issued for 1 to 3, 6, or 12 months. ES visa extension. The ES visa extension is a student visa. Applicants for the ES visa extension need to provide a letter from a registered Cambodian school, as well as evidence of enough funds to support themselves. The ES student visa extension can be issued for 1 to 3, 6, or 12 months. Once your first 30-day E-class visa for Cambodia is finished, you can apply for one of the extension of stay visas listed above from inside Cambodia for 1 to 3, 6, or 12 months. It's advisable to extend it for 6 or 12 months, as these visa types are multiple entry. The 1 and 3-month visas are single entry only, meaning that if you leave for a weekend trip to, say, Bangkok, you'll need to get a new Cambodian visa when you return. 3. K-class visa. The K-class visa is for those of Cambodian descent who hold a foreign passport. It's a free lifetime visa, although you will almost certainly be asked to pay an unofficial fee to get it. Bring any documents that show that you have one Khmer parent, such as a birth certificate, marriage certificate, family book, or Cambodian ID card. A Khmer last name and ability to speak Khmer may be enough, along with a $20 bill of course. Cambodian visas for children. All non-Cambodian children are required to have an E-class visa to enter Cambodia. The cost is the same as for adults. If the child has at least one Cambodian parent, they can apply for a free K-class visa. Children can apply for an ES visa extension without evidence of being enrolled in school, up to the age of 17. After that, they will need to get an EB extension or show evidence of being enrolled in a school. 4. B-class visa. The B-class visa is a free visa for employees of international companies that have a memorandum of understanding with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. You will need to apply in advance for your visa and have a representative meet you at the airport when you arrive. If you are already in Cambodia on another visa type, you will need to leave Cambodia and then re-enter and get a B-class visa. Word of warning. If you are caught with a visa for a purpose that isn't allowed under that visa type, you will be fined $100 and asked to leave the country within 7 days, so don't get a retirement visa if you are working. So, there you have it, the 4 main types of visas available in the Kingdom of Cambodia. Thanks for watching and have a great day.